pecan. So I'm gonna show you how I crack them, how I clean them and eat them, because you do have to clean them. You may use a nutcracker. Don't use your teeth. People use their teeth. Don't pay the dentist. Don't use your teeth. I got some kitchen shears. I guess the little bone crusher part. You can use that. I don't. Depending on how extreme you are, you know. Okay. I usually use pliers. We just didn't have nutcrackers coming up. We didn't have them. So let me get you in there a little bit. Got a nice one. This is a Stewart paper shell. It's the long stem ones. This one was perfectly open on the tree. See, I didn't even have to try to force it this time. I'm like, shut it off. I got these. These ain't my favorite pecan pliers. They're just there. Now this one feels pretty good. Gotta kind of, you know, check the weight on it. If it's hollow, it's probably, you know, let the squirrel find out that it ain't good. But this one feels okay. Let's see. Please, don't overcrack. Don't overcrack. You messed the whole process up. Start middle and around, not too much. Because you still want the meat to be good. Alright. You can see it. Still gonna eat it. Okay. There we go. So that part. I just need a football game. But anyway, it's gonna be parts in there and little ridges that just holds the, you know, the meat of the nut in place. So you gotta be careful not to eat them bitter parts. If you do, you will know. You will know. There you go. Not bad. Here we go. So this is a good piece. You can roast these, you can eat them straight up like this, add them to desserts. You can candy them with like brown sugar and butter and a skillet. So good. The same pecan will cost so much if you went and bought it. But you go out there and take the time, get yourself a little piece, picking it yourself. It's so much better. Everything is right.